The US military has achieved a major milestone when it comes to ballistic missile defense. In a test, an SM-3 Block IIA missile has successfully destroyed a Mach Intercontinental Ballistic Missile (ICBM) target. The US Missile Defense Agency and US Navy said that the test met its primary objective, proving that an SM-3 Block IIA can engage an ICBM threat. U.S. Navy Vice Admiral Jon Hill, the Director of MDA, also said the following in a statement. "This was an incredible accomplishment and critical milestone for the Aegis BMD SM-3 Block IIA program. The department is investigating the possibility of augmenting the ground-based midcourse defense system by fielding additional sensors and weapon systems to hedge against unexpected developments in the missile threat. We've demonstrated that an Aegis BMD-equipped vessel, equipped with the SM-3 Block IIA missile, can defeat an ICBM-class target, which is a step in the process of determining its feasibility as part of an architecture for layered defense of the homeland. My congratulations to the entire test team, including our military and industry partners, who helped us to achieve this milestone." Brian Rosselli, Vice President of Strategic Missile Defense at Raytheon Missiles and Defense, the company responsible for developing the SM-3 Block IIA, in collaboration with Japan's Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, said, "This first-of-its-kind test shows that our nation has a viable option for a new layer of defense against long-range threats. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why SM-3 Block IIA intercepting an ICBM is a major breakthrough. Let's get started." This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The test was mandated by the U.S. Congress to evaluate the feasibility of the SM-3 Block IIA missile's capability to defeat an ICBM threat. It was supposed to be undertaken before the end of 2020, and in that respect, the deadline is met. The primary technical aim of the test has also been achieved since the interception was a success, but now the analysts will assess all the parameters to evaluate the overall performance of the Aegis BMD system and all other assets involved in this test. Viewers may note that missile interception is one of the hardest things to achieve, since it's like hitting a bullet with another bullet, and all the assets will need to work accurately when a real-life situation is encountered. The overall intention was to validate the Aegis ballistic missile defense-equipped warships armed with SM-3 Block IIA could act as a backup for ground-based midcourse defense, or GMD. GMD is designed to protect the U.S. mainland and uses ground-based interceptor (GBI) from land-based launchers. Ground-based midcourse defense, till now, was the only system that's available to the U.S. military, which can intercept intercontinental ballistic missiles (ICBM). Other systems like THAAD can take on only intermediate-range ballistic missiles. This particular test was officially referred to as the Flight Test Aegis Weapon System 44, or FTM-44, and codenamed Stellar Lancer. Viewers may note that this was actually planned for May 2020, but was delayed due to COVID-19. The test was initiated at 2:50 Eastern Standard Time on November 17, 2020, when the Mach ICBM target was fired from the Ronald Reagan Ballistic Missile Defense Test Site on Kwajalein Atoll. According to the U.S. Missile Defense Agency, MDA, The specific missile, which is thought to be a three-stage Northrop Grumman ICBM-T2, climbed toward the broad ocean area northeast of Hawaii. The path of the ICBM was configured in such a manner that it headed toward a target on Hawaii. The target area was envisaged to be defended by USS John Finn, DDG-113, which is a U.S. Navy Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer and deployed in the Pacific. It's to be noted that USS John Finn is equipped with the Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System and is integrated with the Command and Control Battle Management Communications C2BMC network, through which the warship can receive real-time targeting data from other sensors. After receiving the tracking data, a fire control solution was produced by the warship, and it launched the SM-3 Block IIA missile toward the incoming threat. The missile was guided to the target and ultimately destroyed the threat with its kinetic kill vehicle. The kill vehicle doesn't use explosives. It instead physically rams the incoming threat to knock it out. The SM-3 Block IIA features a variety of upgrades over the Block II version. It has a larger, more maneuverable, exo-atmospheric kill vehicle with longer endurance. It also possesses an upgraded infrared targeting system that enables it to better distinguish the incoming warhead among the debris. The missile was primarily designed to take on intermediate and medium-range ballistic missile threats. SM-3 Block IIA is jointly manufactured by Raytheon, Aerojet, and Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. The Block IIA variant has a max speed of 4.5 kilometers per second, or Mach 13.2, and has a range of 1,200 kilometers, or 745 miles, and a service ceiling of 1,050 kilometers, or 650 miles. The missile is accommodated in Mark 41 Vertical Launch System, VLS, present in Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. ICBM interception from a sea-based platform is not achieved by any other nation. It is certainly a breakthrough. On the surface, it looks like defensive weaponry, but there's much more to it, as it can disturb the MAD equilibrium. Mutually Assured Destruction, MAD, is a doctrine of military strategy and national security policy in which full-scale use of nuclear weapons by two or more opposing sides would cause the complete annihilation of both the attacker and the defender. It's based on the theory of deterrence, which holds that the threat of using strong weapons against the enemy prevents the enemy's use of those same weapons. The strategy is a form of Nash equilibrium, in which once armed, neither side has any incentive to initiate a conflict or to disarm. With a more comprehensive ballistic missile defense system, U.S. will be in a position to neutralize North Korean, Iranian, as well as Russian and Chinese missile threats to an extent. This will mean the U.S. will be in a more comfortable position if there's a scenario where it decides to launch missiles against these adversaries, as it will have a defense against retaliation. It was very likely that Russia and China will protest this vehemently, as a capability like this will degrade their deterrence, and this is exactly what happened. Russia has said that the United States kept Moscow in the dark about its anti-ballistic missile strategy. Russian Foreign Ministry spokesperson Maria Zakharova dubbed the test as anti-Russian orientation, while calling out her American colleagues for repeatedly lying about the system. According to Zakharova, the United States has assured Russia that its anti-ballistic missile system cannot take down Russian ICBMs and was meant for threats against Iran and North Korea. Zakharova said that the recent test proves that the United States lied about the system and its ability to strike down Russian ICBMs. As per reports, China is also upset about the test. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.